What's up, guys? It's Tyler Wallace Farm and Sawmill back at it again. It's wet, we're not getting any drier. So check this out. Today, I'm going to be working on two particular items. It's Friday, so I'm doing a little bit of custom sawing. And I've got to cut a 10 by 10, 12 feet long, and a 10 by 10, 10 feet long. And I'm gonna do it out of pine. I got a couple good pine logs over in that area right there that we're gonna get them out of. So I'm gonna take you along for the ride of how we create porch posts. And let's go ahead and cover it now, because I know there's gonna be questions in the comments about, well, pine for porch posts, blah, blah, blah. All right. So my customer's been using these for a long time. Matter of fact, my grandfather's house has got pine porch posts on it, and they've been there since the late 60s. But let's get to the point here. The thing about porch posts in particular that you should keep in mind is porch or wood in general is like a candle wick. And if you put it to where it can wick up moisture, it's gonna wick up moisture and rot over time. So what I advise my customers, and what my grandfather did on his house, and it lasted so long for him, was to use casters. They make porch casters that will set on the bottom of a post and give you a couple inches up off of the ground. And there's different attachment ways. There's a million ways to do it. But anyway, we have good luck out of using these. We've got a couple houses we did 6-7 years ago, and porch posts still look phenomenal. So that's what we're doing. That covers that pine issue. But yeah, check it out. Let's get them sawed up. Okay, guys, did a little digging through my pile. I picked out two particular logs for this order. Like I said, we need a 10 by 10, 12 feet. This is a 14 foot log right here. We're gonna go ahead and cut that 2 feet off, because this is a custom order. I hate to waste the 2 feet, but it's what we need, so we're gonna do it. And I need this 10 foot log here to make a 10 by 10 as well, which I believe it will do fairly easy. It looks to be about a 15 inch diameter log, so that's what we're gonna do. Let me get them, I'm gonna cut one block of this one off to knock it down to 12 feet for what the customer needs. And then we'll move both of these over to the mill deck and we'll get the sawing.
Ah.
tonight, guys, and that is two 10 by 10s, one 10 foot long and one 12 foot long. Got her pith centered up. That log there was a little crooked, so piss a lot of center on that end, but gotta make good posts. And that's how we do it when we get these custom orders of porch posts. They'll cut them to length, and they're gonna be using like a timber frame situation set on casters, and I'm not quite sure what this project in particular he's got going for this, but he called me this morning and said, I need two of them today. And I said, well, I'm your man. Anywho, if you guys like this content, like, comment, and subscribe. I appreciate the all the subscribers we've been gathering lately. We've been getting a good many. We're pushing that near 1,000 mark. So appreciate you guys, and just keep following along for more content.